step closer to a superpower face-to-face with China. President Biden has reached his third stop of a world tour, now in Indonesia, greeted by a Balinese welcome dance. Here in Bali for the G20 summit. But for the president, one long-anticipated reunion takes on global importance. Meeting Xi Jinping for the first time as president, boosted by new political resilience back home.
I know I'm coming in stronger, but I don't need that. I know Xi Jinping. I spent more time with many other world leaders. I know him well. He knows me.
Their personal history deepened during a 2011 tour of China when both men were vice president. Tomorrow, they come together in Bali, a face-off over economic competition, global influence, and rising tensions over security from Taiwan to Russia.
We just got to figure out where the red lines are, what are the most important things to each of us going into the next 2 years.
Leading up to the China meeting, the president sat down with leaders from Japan and South Korea, key allies to help balance the rise of China and to confront the dangers of a nuclear North Korea.
And North Korea continues provocation for provocative behavior. This partnership is even more important than it's ever been.
Kelly O'Donnell's with me now from Bali. It's not just President Xi, Mr. Biden's meeting. He's also meeting some new leaders for the first time, right, Kelly?
That's right. Some direct personal diplomacy for the president is still ahead. He'll be meeting with Italy's Giorgia Meloni, and he'll have his first chance to sit down with the United Kingdom's new prime minister, Rishi Sunak. Kate?